So this is the Origins Mix and Mask British Beauty Blogger box. It's not going to work. Today I'm not going to be able to talk. But yes, this is the box. I really, really, really wanted to try the tinted moisturiser that came in it. So that's why, mainly, that I bought the box. I also wanted to try the Drink Up Intensive. I'm going to try and keep those up the top there and show you how it came. This was in a box, but obviously I've taken it out because I've already done my first impressions of it. I have it on my face at the moment. I will jump into that in a minute, but I just wanted to quickly go through what was in the box. There is the, I forgot what it's called already. SPF 15 Energy Boosting Moisturiser, tinted moisturiser, I don't know. The tinted moisturiser. Then there's this one, which is like a face primer for before you put your mask on. There's this one, which is a foaming cleanser. Then there's a clay mask, a peel off mask, the Drink Up Intensive, which is what I really wanted to try. And then there's three of these little pods. This one's a charcoal one. Never tried a charcoal mask, quite excited about that. This one is a problem skin one. I'll see how that goes. I don't know whether it might be a bit harsh for my skin. And the Drink Up little shot pod thing. So I'm really excited to try all of those masks, but this is what it's about today. I will come back and tell you about the masks at some point, I'm sure. But yes, I am going to jump in now and show you what happened 5 minutes ago, and then come back later in the day and show you how it's worn. Okay, so this is an energy boosting moisturiser. So I'm going in with it as if it was moisturiser. I would normally put moisturiser on within a few minutes of putting my foundation on because my skin is fairly dry. But I don't know how it works with a tinted moisturiser. So we're going to give it a go. I can't even get the lid off, which is a really good start. There we go. So it's coming out like my Body Shop one that I like, with the little grainy bits in. I don't know, do you rub it first and put it on your face, or do you just, my camera is the wrong way up, sounds like the weirdest thing to say. I keep losing you because my camera is the wrong way up, and I've got to look at myself a little bit as well. Just going to go for it, blob it on and rub. So as to avoid my eyes, don't know if it's something that's going to make my eyes flare up, so I will avoid them fairly well at the moment. Feels nice, feels quite like a moisturiser. It's a bit thicker than most of the moisturisers I use. I quite like the really lightweight ones. It's probably thicker than most of the foundations that I use as well. But I'm thinking that because it's a foundation moisturiser, I will get away with that. I'm a little bit shiny. I don't know if I'm a better complexion than I was before. I'm going to have to go and have a look in the mirror to see, if we're honest. But it doesn't seem to have done too bad a job. I'm more than happy with it as what it says it's going to be. It's not too dark a colour, which is quite nice. It smells rather nice, and yeah. I'm going to put the rest of my makeup on over the top and see what we think. Okay, so I'm back. I have no idea if I'm even vaguely in the same place, if we're honest. Makeup's covered over the top of it really, really nicely. I didn't add too much colour. I put the clear complexion from, is it Rimmel? Yeah, Rimmel. I put that on so that there wasn't too much colour. On my eyes, I'm wearing the Peanut Butter and Jelly palette. I am wearing Tantalising Taupe as my lipstick. And my blush is Blush Baby by MAC. Like this one, it's a really good one. I've got a little bit of bronzer on, which is my Essence one. Still losing that little viewfinder, can't help it. But yeah, it's all covered really well, and I'm really pleased with it. I think this could be quite a nice summer one. And I'll do a bit of a wear test today and tell you how it's lasted. We are now 4.5 hours later, and it's done okay. For a tinted moisturiser, I'm not going to say that it's the same as a foundation, but for what I wanted it to do, it's done fine. I mean, if I was going to go into town or something, or somewhere warm, and I just wanted a quick layer, I mean, I probably would go makeup free, but if I wanted a quick layer, then it's done exactly what it's meant to do. Of all places, it's worn off a little bit here and here, which also had blusher on the top, so that's a bit interesting. Whether or not I've touched there, I can't think that I've sat like this, but it's worn off here and here and on my chin, and a little bit kind of on my forehead, but I don't think that it looks awful. I don't have a problem with it at all. I think it's been quite moisturising. My face doesn't feel as rough to the touch as it did this morning, so it's done its moisturising as well as doing its foundation bit. So I definitely thumbs up for that one. I'm pleased that I had a go. Sorry, I'm getting a message. But yes, I will see you soon. The next video may possibly be more professional, but don't hold your breath.